You're listening to someone soloing and they play something instantly recognizable. What was that from? Did they just quote a nursery rhyme? In this video, we'll talk about quoting in your solos. Hi, my name is Jason Klobnak, and I'm a jazz trumpeter from Denver, Colorado that helps musicians find a better way to improvise. If you're looking for a quick jazz improv tip that will help your soloing, then you've come to the right place. One of my all-time favorite jazz soloists is tenor saxophonist Dexter Gordon. I love his sound and his immensely melodic playing. He's also one of the first players that comes to mind when you start thinking about quoting. Practically every solo he's ever played has some type of quote inside. If you're wondering, Jason, what's quoting and why is that important in improvisation? It's actually really simple. Similar to writing, it's when you quote something someone else has said. Usually, they're short melodic fragments or statements that are instantly recognizable to your audience. Dexter Gordon was infamous for playing parts of nursery rhymes, patriotic songs, and other popular tunes of the day. Thinking of two tunes right now where he straight up plays Pop Goes the Weasel. Sometimes quotes like that are funny and meant to be tongue-in-cheek. Other times it happens in the moment because it fits the line you just played. It's also a great way to add melodic elements to your solo if you feel like you need to break up the monotony of playing that game of eighth note connect the dots. Can be a challenge though. Do you just throw the quote in out of the blue? In this video, let's show you how you can use them. The first step is to pick a quote that's short, melodic, and recognizable. Could you use an obscure quote? Well, sure, if you only want a few people to get it. Otherwise, it's best to have your audience go, "Oh man, was that the line to that one cartoon we watched as kids?" To keep this video short and interesting, I'm going to quote Nana Nana Boo Boo. It's recognizable, right? Now, can you play it in more than one key? If the quote is short and recognizable, this is a great exercise to work out your ears in other keys. Next, look at your line and analyze it. Figure out if it fits in a key area or if the last note can be used as a target. This helps you determine where the quote might fit. If it works over a key area, then you can experiment with places to use it on progressions that hang around a key. If it doesn't, figure out what chords the last note of the line will fit because it becomes your target. Finally, try and put it into context. Practice playing something right before it and right after it. Do this process until it becomes comfortable. You can also experiment with it by changing up the rhythm, turning it into a pattern sequence, or whatever your creativity takes you. For Nana Nana Boo Boo, it checks all of those boxes. It can fit over major, over minor, and I can use the last note as a target. I'm going to show you how I might use this quote over the progression to Alone Together and give you a chance to try it out too. There's a streaming link in the description below of one of my band's latest albums. I play a few quotes. For bonus points, leave a comment below on what those quotes were, or leave a comment about your favorite quote used by your favorite musicians. I hope you've enjoyed this video and that it has added some value or benefit to your playing in some way. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and that bell that's right next to it that lets you know when another video comes out. And if you know any other musician that might find this useful, you can share it with them too. Until then, my name is Jason Klobnak, and I'll see you on the next one.